of the International University Sports Federation 3-on-3 basketball competition. This is the women's final. The Chinese Culture University from the island of Taiwan. And they're playing the University of Regina from Canada. Teams are being introduced to the fans here. It's always a great occasion here in the province of Xiamen. Rukiao University honored to stage this competition for the second year running. Enthusiastic courtside announcer here, just introducing the players from the University of Regina, Charlotte Cote, Michaela Klesinger, Avery Pierce, and Kiana Ping-Gilles.
Number two, Michaela Klesinger.
3-on-3, basketball of course, the most popular urban sport in the opinion of the International Olympic Committee. Populous urban sport in the world, and that's the main reason why it will be in the Tokyo Olympics in 2020 alongside the full-scale basketball, full-size basketball, 5-on-5 full court. A major difference, 3-on-3 played into just one hoop. It's Vanessa Devlin, the referee, or one of the officials, co-official Tan Shelton. So the Canadian side in red against the Taiwanese side in white. All of these players have ranking numbers, and you can tell by the popularity of 3-on-3 basketball, many of these players, their ranking is in the 20,000s. Looking through, I didn't see any rankings higher than many thousands, let's say. 12 there for the Chinese Culture University is Lin Yuting. And it is a toss of a coin that starts the game off. Team that wins the toss can decide whether they start or not. Oh, that's so easy. A lovely passing there from the Chinese Culture University, and they get underway in an instant. And poor passing again from the Canadian side, and the foul, it's an and one as well, so 2-0. And hardly blinked to get that score. So a great start from the Chinese Culture University team, and this is 13 Cheng Xiliu with the and one, which she fails to complete. The rebound there by Kiana Ping-Gilles, and the two! Goodness me, instant offense from the Canadian side, it's 2 apiece. Nice fake. And inside again. Well, we've had some low scoring games throughout the 4 days of this tournament. But these two teams off to the races so quickly. 3 each and not a minute gone yet. Yeah, it's good defense, good no foul. Offensive rebound, new shot clock for Chinese Culture University. Good shot block. Charlotte Cote there, the enforcer. As clean as they come, the block. Shot clock on 6. Yeah, when you check in, just make sure your defense is steady. That's a good defensive stance there. No foul, great body position from Michaela Klesinger. And here she is on the restart. Oh, great screen from Ping-Gilles. Can they make the most of it though? That's a tough pass to make. Will that be a held ball? No. Somehow they get the pass away. And the 2-pointer as well. What a wonderful hustle. Low pin made the two, but it was all about the hustle. Shot off the glass, no good. This time it is good. 5-4. Chinese Culture team by 1. play. I was about to say the game being played at a million miles an hour, but it always is on three against three. 6-4 now, the team in white. That's a travel, surely. Well, it's just out of bounds. Dribbling in traffic, Kiana Pingjules, and she takes a break. Remember, four players in each team. Just three on court at any one time. You can sub any time you like. Pull-up jump shot is good. That's Yang Qing. Under the circumstances, a three-point lead is a big lead. And 13 gets the rebound. Cheng Sihu. This is great ball movement from the Chinese culture team. And they get the rebound as well with a new 12. They do move the ball brilliantly, the Chinese team, Chinese Culture University, and they get another offensive rebound. It's a four-point lead now for the team in white. This is the final of the 2017 World University 3-on-3 League. And there's a foul. Is that a shooting foul? I think it is. The shot clock was on zero when the foul was committed. Or rather, the foul's committed and then the shot clock registered zero. So it is a shooting foul. Just one shot if you're fouled inside the arc. The foul shot is good by Avery Pierce. And courtside announcer getting very, very excited. Well, I was about to say good boxing out, good shot block in the end. Good shot block there from Yang Qing. And it is her team in possession. A two-pointer again, and again, Lin Xuting. It's a five-point lead now for the team in white, the Chinese University, Chinese Culture University. Shot clock on one. Now, it is, well, the shot clock violation is called. There's that two-pointer, which made it a five-point lead. And we have a timeout with 6:49 to go in the final. And Chinese Culture University lead, the University of Regina, by five. Yeah, our courtside announcer getting very, very excited. Watching highlights of the final. Chinese Culture University got to this final by beating one of the host sides, Kang Normal University from China, and University of Regina got here by beating the Hungarian side, University of Physical Education. What can the Canadians do to get themselves back into this game? Still a long time to go. What they don't want, though, is a high-scoring game with the Taiwanese team getting to 21. That's a great spin move, all to no avail, though. Now, there's an offensive foul, I think. No, a defensive foul. Holding foul off the ball. Let's have a look, see what happened. Well, it's an illegal screen, I think. Yeah. No shots for an offensive foul. Unless, of course, it's unsportsmanlike. You don't see that very often, unsportsmanlike fouls in 3-on-3. The 2-pointer is good. The Canadian side back into it. Michaela Klesinger. The Taiwanese team do move well off the ball, though. Now there's a possession to University of Regina there. Remember this event last year, and one of the outstanding bits about the whole tournament last year and this year indeed, the sportsmanship is tremendous. No qualms, no queering officials or malice involved in fouls or anything. It really is a great spectacle. Wonderful sportsmanship being shown, men and women. Shot clock on five. Oh, that's a clumsy loss. number one for University of Regina. Charlotte Cott there couldn't hang on to the pass. Long two-pointer, he's up again. Well, at the moment, the Chinese Culture University are killing the Canadians from outside. It's a five-point lead. Still a long time to go, though, and they steal the ball. And then go inside for easy. Oh, I was about to say easy two. It looked easy, but what a block there from Charlotte Cote. That's got to go in. Misses by a long way. And the Chinese Culture team didn't need to box out. It dropped conveniently into their hands. Shot clock on three. Oh, that's a crazy shot. It had to be, though. Good defense from University of Regina. The two is good. It's back to a three-point game now. Great two-pointer there from Charlotte Cote. And she comes out to be replaced by Avery Pierce. Exactly halfway through this final. That is, if we go the full 10 minutes. Well, I was about to say there was a toe on the line there, so it would have been a one. It didn't go in anyway. Good hustling from Michaela Klesinger. Good hustle. Oh, that's good switching man to man, but eventually, I was about to say, University of Regina, good switching man to man, but eventually someone just fell over and allowed the easy one-pointer. Four and a half to go, and that's a shooting foul, and I tell you what, Kiana Ping-Gilles there, she's the master of getting the one and one. She scores, she's fouled, she's got a bonus to come. She got two of those opportunities in the semi-final, and here in the final, this is her first opportunity. This to make it a two-point game, which she does. She completes the two-point play. On the turnaround, oh, the rebound, you've got to box out. There's a mismatch there on the box out, and that's an air ball. University of Regina there, a little lucky to get possession there. Poor boxing out, or non-existent boxing out, followed by an air ball. It's in, it's a one-point game. Ooh, brilliant penetration there. Under four to go. Good defense from the Canadians. Oh, he rolled around and in. It's a two-point game again. All that work and then a poor pass. Well, you have to credit the Chinese Culture team. Super defense, deny the pass. There's that penetration from Avery Pierce. And we have a timeout. This is the final of the 2017 World University League 3-on-3. Watching highlights. And we've had a few two-pointers. We've had a two-point play as well from Kiana Ping-Gilles. Crowd getting very enthusiastic. Remember, the men's final coming up after this. So it's a two-point game with 3:44 to go. Unless, of course, the team gets the 21. An easy rebound there for Charlotte Cote. There's Cote again on the jump shot. She misses, and the rebound is by Lopin. Well, it's a two-point shootout at the moment. And several misses in a row there. Another two-pointer, another miss, and the rebound again, Kiana Ping-Gilles. Good Dinard defense. Ticking down to the 3-minute mark, still anybody's game. If that goes in, it'll be a four-pointer. It does go in. That's a big, big score from Cheng Xiu. Now what can the Canadians do to respond? Well, there's no point in going one on three. That's good team defense from the team from Taiwan. Nice pass off and the miss now. Whose possession is that? It's a 4-point lead for the Chinese culture team. Remember, if they get to 21, oh, the first team to 21 wins it. And that's a long way. The prospect of that is a long way for the Canadians at the moment. They're only on 12. Still 2.5 to go. That shot is blocked brilliantly indeed. And a fake pass outside as well. That was about to be intercepted. The two-pointer up and in and out. It rolled around and out, and there's a foul on the play. And I think it's Kiana Ping-Jules who was fouled. Yeah, number 10 there is Yang Jing, smiling. Here we go, here's the foul, let's have a look. Well, might say that Kiana Ping-Jules there rather fortuitously got that foul called in her favour. Shot clock on 2, it's got to go up and in, and it went in and out. That's an easy pass inside, and the rebound is Kiana Ping-Jules. Well, she's forcing it somewhat, looking for the foul, not getting it. Good no call there from the official. And the 2. That's almost a dagger from Lo Pin. It's a 6-point game now with just over 100 seconds remaining in the women's final. It's got to go up, and the Canadians fail to beat the shot clock. Substitution, or is it a timeout? No, just a substitution from the Canadian side. Trailing by 6 with 99 seconds remaining in the final. Chinese culture team on 4 fouls. Remember, when you get to 6, they're shooting fouls. That's a 1-pointer which misses, and the rebound is eventually grabbed by the Canadian side. Avery Pierce. They need a couple of 2s. Well, they need 3 2s actually to tie. That's an air ball, and she chases down her own rebound, but it didn't hit the rim, so it's a shot clock violation. 73 seconds remaining, and it is the Chinese Culture University roster who are leading by 6. Now really, if they run the clock a few times now, they should win the game. Well, they're leading by 7 now. Perhaps that was the dagger. Well, a poor pass there, and now it's run the clock time, I suspect, from the Chinese culture team. They recognized it, and they get the rebound as well. New shot clock, and the turnaround, 20 to 12. That should be enough with 40 seconds remaining. Have we got a held ball? We've got a scramble on the floor, everybody. Our opponents pick each other up. Yeah, I suspect you might say that Michaela Klesinger there annoyed somewhat. She's come out. Now, the Chinese culture team are 1 point away from winning the final. If that goes in, the buzzer will go. Shot clock on 4. There it is. It's a 1-point game. 1-point score rather. So 21-12. The Chinese Culture University have beaten the University of Regina from Canada 21-12 to win the gold medal at the World University League Finals here. Here at the University of Hokkaido in Xiamen province in China. So a terrific win from the team from the island of Taiwan. The island, the capital of which is Taipei. And 21-12, the Chinese Culture University team won it. So just to round up, Qinghai Normal University beat the University of Physical Education from Hungary 17-8 to win the bronze medal. The silver medal goes to the University of Regina from Canada, and the gold medal to the Chinese Culture University from Taipei. Terrific performance from the team in white. Several mismatches in there, and the team in white made the best use of them, scoring a lot of 2s, and they've won the final 21-12. So the gold medal goes to a team from Taiwan. These are the highlights of that final, and it was a dynamic outside game from the Chinese Culture University that won them the game. 21-12, they've beaten University of Regina.
FISU, today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.